Dr. DeSilva and I would like to encourage you to memorize your polyatomic ions before class begins. It'll make it much easier and you can learn more and you'll be more successful in chemistry. So I'm going to give you a little introduction about polyatomic ions. There's a list of polyatomic ions that have been posted on Canvas. You should try to memorize as many as you can, preferably all of them. So an example of a polyatomic ion would be SO4 2 minus, which is sulfate. Now notice a few things. The S is a capital, the O is a capital, the 4 is a subscript, and the 2 minus is a superscript. It's important that you always write it exactly in that fashion. This means you have a sulfur, 4 oxygens, and the total thing has a charge, the total ion has a charge of negative 2, and it's called sulfate. This ion is called sulfite. It's almost the same, except you'll see there's only 3 oxygens, and instead of an A, there's an I. And you'll learn more about this later, but the way I like to remember is I think it's lighter, it has less oxygens, so it's lighter, it has an I. There's another ion that's not polyatomic, but is an ion. And this is sulfide. It's a sulfur with a negative 2 charge. It ends in IDE. Make sure you do not mix up the ions that don't have an oxygen with ions that do have an oxygen. When it ends in IDE, there's no oxygen. When it ends in ate or ite, you do have an oxygen. There are a few exceptions to that, but most of the time they will follow those rules. Now, students memorize